all in all, Lord, I thank you again for another opportunity to stand before your people, God. And Lord, I pray that you will allow murder to decrease, that you may increase. And Lord, I pray that you will let the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, be acceptable in your sight. Oh Lord, for you are my strength and you are my redeemer. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
I'm going to read a scripture, and we come from the 9th chapter of Matthew. And I'm just going to read the 9th verse.
Amen.
And it reads, "And as Jesus passed forth from thence, he saw a man named Matthew sitting at the seat of custom. And he said unto him, Follow me. And he arose and followed him."
Praise God.
And like I say, if I was to use a study, it'd be the benefits of following Jesus. We see in the 9th chapter of Matthew, even starting at the 9th through the 13th verse, where Jesus was passing by, he saw Matthew and asked him to come follow me. But in the scripture ahead, we know that Jesus had healed a man with the leprosy.
Mm-hmm.
He healed a man with the palsy.
Oh, yeah.
He even healed Peter's mother-in-law.
All right.
Then as he left to go into his own town, as he was passing through, like I said, he saw this man, Matthew. And Matthew was a Jew who was appointed by the Romans to be the area's tax collector.
All right.
We all know what during that time, and probably they ain't cared a whole lot for today. Tax collectors weren't the most popular people.
Uh-huh.
They were kind of despised by the people because they had a reputation of cheating the people out of their money. They were charging what they wanted to and hold back so much, you know, for themselves. So
all right.
That was kind of a lucrative career for them.
Amen.
And then they also supported Rome and the people, some the Jews didn't like that.
Amen.
But when Jesus called Matthew to be one of his disciples, Matthew got up and followed, leaving his career. So like I said, it was a lucrative career. Like some of us nowadays, when Jesus is speaking to us and tell us to do something, like I say, we know the boss, we should know the boss.
Amen.
All right.
Sometimes we may have jobs and be making, you know, and say, I'm making good money on my job. Mm-hmm. I can't quit my job.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
All right.
But see, if Jesus, when Jesus speaks to us and tells us to do something, he's already got the way made.
Amen.
Amen.
That's the benefit of following him. He already supplied all our needs.
Amen.
And he lets us know if we do what he tells us to do, then he will also give us the desires of our
heart. All right. Yeah. All right.
Sometimes the decision to follow Christ requires us to make a difficult or painful choice.
Uh-huh.
Like I say, sometimes people don't want to do, you know, don't want to drop things or I might have to do this, and if I just quit this job. See, Matthew got right on up. He left that job alone.
All right.
But sometimes we feel like, well, if I got to quit this, I don't know. Get away in the auction. I won't be able to, I don't know if I'll be able to keep this.
Uh-huh.
I'm getting, right now I kind of got it going on.
That's right.
Not knowing that he is the one that supplies. He's the one that gives you the job.
Yes.
Amen. Amen.
And as Matthew did, we must leave those things behind that will hinder our walk with Christ.
Amen.
Matthew was cheating the people by him being a tax collector. I can imagine he had to do some little cheating too.
All right.
Holding back, you know, where I charge
Ed Whitfield, $80 for a tax, but really like $40, so I got $40 from him.
That's right.
All right.
But when he got, decided to follow Jesus, when Jesus told him, his life would change. And Jesus went to his house, Matthew invited other people to come. And ain't that just like Jesus? And some of the Pharisees thought, you know, that they were sitting eating with the lowlife. That's what we do today sometimes. Somebody we think ain't up to our standard, we won't call them lowlife.
Go ahead now.
But Jesus, he don't have respect for people. He loves the sinner. Just like he loves us, he don't love sin.
Amen.
He don't love us sin.
Amen.
And we have all sinned and come short of glory.
Amen.
But see, the Pharisees, they were concerned about their own self, about their holiness.
Yeah.
They didn't want to help nobody.
All right.
Just like we have people today, we have a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof.
Thank you, Jesus.
Ask somebody to help you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Not everybody, but sometimes we as Christians, we say we're Christians. But if we are a Christian or a child of God, we'll do what we're supposed to do.
Amen.
But if we're like the Pharisees, then we'll have our little form of holiness in God.
All right.
But then we don't want to share with anybody. And when I say share, it's not necessarily, sometimes a lot of times, you know, we think, well, it's finances. It's not all the time finances.
Amen.
We can share the word of God with somebody.
Amen.
Share love.
All right.
Yes.
All right.
Always be able to give somebody a word to encourage them.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's what God wants us to do. We need to be examples. Follow Christ's example.
Amen.
And then, you know, to ask them, Jesus let them know, they said, wanted to know why they were sick, you know, with those folks. Jesus said, the ones that are sick, you know, don't need a physician if you're not sick.
Oh,
yeah. He said, I came to call the sinners to repentance.
Amen.
Now, if we say that we are Christians, we are living for Christ every day, doing the very best that we know.
All right.
But then we don't want the sinner man to be blessed.
Amen.
If we say we got it going on like this, then we're supposed to be healthy.
Yes.
If I'm healthy, what I got, I went to the doctor today. But if I'm really healthy in a natural state, what am I going to the doctor for?
All right.
That defeats the purpose.
Amen.
That's what Jesus was kind of trying to let them know. There are benefits in following me.
Oh, yes. Thank you, Jesus.
There is many benefits in following Christ.
Oh, yes. Yes.
And when we give a sinner the word of somebody that haven't yet come into the fold, how do we know? Sometimes we think they're not listening. They're not even paying any attention. That's not true all the time.
Amen.
I was told a lot of times, people used to talk to me, and I probably was standing and looking at, but I was really listening.
Amen.
They probably thought, she ain't paying me no mind. But you know, when I would get home or get by myself, that word was, it was going down on the inside.
All right.
And so that's what we have to do. Be able to give somebody an encouraging word.
Amen.
And be like Matthew did. He didn't hesitate for a moment to follow Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus gave him a new life,
just
like he would do for us.
Yes.
Matthew then was not only accepted as a person, he was no longer a tax collector, person that was despised. And the only tool, how about God will equip us sometime long before He give us a position sometimes.
Amen.
And sometimes, you know, we think, well, I got to get saved before I'm ready. And which we can't step out just going in the cup, you know. But God is already, Ellen Whitfield, don't you know God equipped you years ago to be a Bible preacher?
Amen.
Believe it or not.
Amen.
Bishop, I know you were equipped before then.
Oh, yes.
And I tell this story sometime. Elder Brian, when he was about 10 or 11 years old, and even before, but he was really no reading good then. And it's nothing I'm proud of. But me and my husband weren't living, we wasn't living any kind of life. Not a godly life.
Right.
And I had several Bible in every room. And honest and truth, as you know how I said, let a Bible lay and collect dust. That's what we're doing. You know, the Lord wants us to
right.
be real.
Amen.
That's right.
And what really sure enough got me, every night, he would get a Bible and lay down on that floor and be reading the Bible.
All right.
And one night, I mean, something really touched me. I didn't say, I would look at watching me every night. And Lord, Lord spoke to me now. This child got something else. They're reading his Bible.
Amen.
And you might have been there acting fool.
All right.
It's time you straighten it.
Amen.
That's right.
And we know when the voice of the Lord speaks to
us.
And I repented and I asked the Lord to clean me up.
All right.
And we ask him to clean us up and we mean it. Be sincere from my heart, God will do that.
Yes,
he
will. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, sir. And sometimes, like I say, when we don't realize sometimes that God is equipping us before we get into certain positions. When Matthew began to follow Jesus, we know he left it being a tax collector. But I believe he took his pen with him.
All right, now.
Because Jesus gave him the position of being a recorder.
All right.
So Matthew being a recorder, you know, evidently he was good at keeping records. And he began to watch and see everything that was going on. And he kept records up. And he compiled those records to become the book of Matthew.
All right. Yeah. All right.
So just know that Jesus, there is benefits in following him.
All right. Yes.
Great benefits.
Thank you, Chief.
Have you ever been through a sorrowful time? And sometimes we know it's a sorrowful. I say, for instance, that we have lost family members. But God will give you the strength.
That's right.
Oh, yes.
And sometimes people look at you like when you lose a family member, they look at us when Christ dwells on the inside. That ain't bothering.
Okay.
It is bothering.
Yes. Yeah.
But we got somebody to help us go
That's
through.
Right.
Amen.
That's right. Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
He tells us take our burdens to him and leave them there.
Thank you, Jesus.
And then sometimes we'll see people that realize that Christ is not dwelling on the inside. And they just howl and act a fool.
All right.
And I don't mean that they're not, Because it's something they just, sometimes we can do a lot of show.
Thank you, Jesus.
But God will give us strength to go through anything when
He
lives on the inside.
Amen.
And He said, greater is He that is in us, than he that is in the world.
Amen.
So we need to be like Matthew Church. We need to make a choice. Because God gives us a mind to make a free will choice. He's not going to break down, you know. He said, knocking at the door of your heart. But if we open up, he'll come in and
serve us.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
He's not going to force anything on us.
Thank you.
Sometimes man will try to force you to do certain things or make us do, But Christ is so good to us. He said, I'm going to let you have a choice. You can make up your own mind which way you want to go.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, God.
And can't nobody do us like him.
Amen.
Can't nobody love us like him.
Amen.
And
his
sister was singing a song, When I See Jesus.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah.
Thank
when
you,
I see Jesus. Amen.
All right.
All of our sorrow.
Oh.
Yes.
All of our heartache.
Thank
yes.
you.
No more high blood pressure. No
yeah.
more pain.
Hallelujah.
When I see Jesus. Hallelujah.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Jesus.
Oh, bless mm-hmm. you, God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When we see Jesus, too. We'll be with us. But we will not be having any more trouble.
All right.
The weary will be at rest.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
When I see Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I can't sing this song, but it sounded good.
Amen. Amen.
So in my closing, I would just like to say, let us be at the as Matthew was, regardless of what we are doing,
mm-hmm.
what our title or what our position, mm-hmm. when Christ say, come follow me, let us take off.
Amen.
Don't ponder on it.
Amen.
And when we take off, we know he got the way made.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
He got it all in control.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And my brother, Ever William Sutton said, Church, I just love the Lord on tonight. I really do.
Amen.
Yes.
And I believe everybody in here loves the Lord. And he loves
oh,
us.
Yeah.
We can't
oh, yes.
do too bad
oh, yeah.
that he won't love us.
All right. Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
Ain't that something?
Hallelujah.
He don't love the things we do wrong.
Amen.
And the Bible says that he'll never leave us nor forsake us.
That's right.
And somehow we'll say, you know, I felt like Christ was so, Jesus was so far away from us.
Yeah.
But he didn't leave us.
No.
Amen.
If I'm standing here with Ella Whitfield, and she's sitting in the same place, but I keep moving over here.
Amen.
Now who lives?
Amen.
But God is good, church, and he's
yes,
good
he
all
is.
The time.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
And I'll ask that when you come out, please.
Praise God.
Thank you.